In any case, what she really wanted right after the accident is to show a print, a human print, either a fingerprint, a hand, because that print, it really talks about an absence.
Pero no en un sentido metafórico, sino que es algo que cualquiera de nosotros hace esa conexión. Uno ve una huella y en la escena anterior vimos los chicos tocando el vidrio, uno piensa en los chicos, aunque sea muy rápido, piensa en los chicos, piensa en los chicos que ya no están, y en ese accidente, y me parece que eso todo junto va generando algo, va generando una... Es un proceso de pensamiento, y a mí me parece que esas son las cosas que me parece crecen, van colectando detalles, y el espectador va juntando esos detalles y va armando algo en su cabeza, ¿no?
As a meaning, in a metaphorical way, actually, we see the handprint and we've seen the kids before playing in the car, so we know the kids are not there, and so we start, at least briefly, we think about the kids and the kids that are not there, so that kind of like starts a train of thought, and you start collecting little things to put together and, you know, building that up.
We have time for one more in the back there, you sir. Yeah.
My question sort of follows up on this question up here before. I think that the kind of cinematic universe that you create is interesting with respect to Argentina in general, right? Because when we think of Argentina, everybody thinks of Buenos Aires and, you know, this heavily metropolitan kind of space, very very urban, and this is a very different Argentina, right in the north, and with this much stronger indigenous presence on the border with Bolivia. And so I guess just beginning with that, I was just kind of thinking about this idea that people talk about these days of the new Argentinian cinema, and I was just wondering if you could talk about you know, kind of, if you see yourself as a filmmaker sort of in this broader context of some kind of wave of new Argentinian filmmakers, or if you see yourself sort of following a different line and in connection with, you know, this idea of being making films located in Salta as opposed to this other kind of version of Argentina.
Con dificultad me veo a mí misma como filmmaker, pero con más dificultad como parte de la familia de los directores argentinos.
I can hardly see myself as a filmmaker to start with, so I don't find myself within any group or the new Argentine cinema either.
Pero no por esa vanidad de querer ser único, sino sencillamente porque yo siento mi cine muy en deuda con las tradiciones orales, con la conversación, con los cuentos de mi abuela, mucho más pertenezco a ese mundo y quizás a una cierta literatura argentina que al cine.
Basically, she really connects. She doesn't mean anything that being better or different or unique, but she relates better to like the tales her grandmother would tell her and to literature and that oral stories that people tell to each other more than to the actual cinema. So it really comes from a different place.
Y respecto de la nueva ola argentina, notablemente han aparecido una enorme cantidad de directores muy talentosos y lo cual en otros países sucede normalmente con cada generación. En Argentina lo que sucedió y lo que creo hace más visible a este grupo es que hubo un periodo que fue un agujero en la cultura y en la historia argentina, que fue la dictadura.
So this new wave of Argentinian cinema, it does exist. There's a lot of people and new directors that are very creative and very good, and she thinks that in every country that happens with each generation, you get that kind of thing. But basically had been a void in Argentina in terms of culture. That was when we had the dictatorship. So that void being so present, whatever came after that, made it clearly that it was like a new wave.
En realidad es sencillamente una generación que se incorporaba al cine, a la industria, desde todos puntos de vista, ¿no? Como técnicos, actores, en todas las áreas.
But actually it was just a generation, a new generation of people, you know, devoting themselves to the movies, not only directing, but also acting and you know, camera, sound, crews in general.
Y lo que sí no es un grupo ni política, ni estética, ni filosóficamente que funcione como grupo, ni existen entre nosotros reuniones o situaciones donde haya grandes discusiones sobre estos temas, que digamos no es la Nouvelle Vague, más allá de las diferencias, no es un grupo con esa organicidad, ¿no?
So it's not really like the Nouvelle Vague, it's just a group, but they don't really share the same kind of aesthetics, or they don't get together to discuss any of these things. They're just like different people that just happen to be,
De hecho, entre todos nosotros hay algunos que quieren hacer un cine comercial clásico, hay otros que hacen un cine extremadamente experimental, hay de todo.
So within that same group you have very many different kind of things. You have people that really want to do just commercial films, and then you have people that are really out there and want to be really crafty and blah blah blah, and then you have a little bit of everything.
Lucrecia, thank you so much for being here and sharing The Headless Woman with us. And I just want to remind everyone that tomorrow night, the double feature of La Cienega and The Holy Girl, if you haven't seen them, Lucrecia will be back for more.
I totally get her. It's the same thing as the Colombian letter. We all in traditional African American culture.